Hello and welcome back for another presentation in your World Regional Geography course. This time we're going to introduce the realm of East Asia. So let's get going. So East Asia is surrounded by mountain ranges to the west, Russia and Mongolia to the north, and Southeast Asia to the south. The Three Gorges Dam on the Yangtze River is known in China as the New China Dam. Not only the largest dam in the world, its hydroelectric production system is the largest on Earth. The river system is the world's third largest, after the Nile and the Amazon. Although, the main purpose at this point is hydroelectric energy, the original purpose was specifically due to prevent flooding. The earliest Chinese dynasty dates back about 2200 BC. It was located in the rich northern China plain. Organized as a political system, Chinese dynasties created the Chinese state, which provided for a continuous transfer of power, ideas, and culture from one generation to another. On the right-hand side, I chose the East Asia map that shows the different climate types. As we can see, it's incredibly diverse. There's an area of variation. There's types A, C, B, H, and D, depending on its latitude and relationship with its terrain. On the bottom right-hand side, we can see the different dynasties. This is dating back from 1911 to present time, which I thought was pretty interesting to see how it's been spread up. So you have Chinese dynasties and European colonialism ended in 1911. It then turned into the Chinese Republic, and then you had these different areas in which it split, most of which ended by World War II or the death of Mao Zedong. Now, looking at the population density and relief, I chose these maps in particular. So we've got our density, dot density on the left, you've got your relief on the right. The one on the left really subdivides what we consider the population arcs. We're able to observe this in East Asia, such as the inner western, the inner, and then the outer arc. And we can see that as we kind of work our way outwards, it becomes more populous. Then looking at the raised relief map, we can see that there's perhaps a reason why. Looking specifically at, as an example, closer to Nepal. When we're looking north of Nepal, we're looking at incredibly high altitude and elevation. So again, you might want to take this idea and go back one slide to just look at some of the comparisons within the types of climate to locate where areas of perhaps deserts might be, and how does that play a relationship on population density. So let's talk about emerging China. So China can be divided into regions utilizing various criteria such as politics, economics, natural regions that have been set up by topography, as also as climate. An autonomous region exists as a compromise between China and the regions that would prefer to be totally independent and that have a large non-Han or ethnic minority population. China's communist government is controlled by the Chinese Communist Party, which is protected and guaranteed powers by the country's constitution. China is considered an authoritarian state, complete with heavy restrictions on the internet, the press, freedom of assembly, reproductive rights, and the freedom of religion. Economic trade from the West has created more openness with travel and business, which has begun to challenge or erode the hard-line politics of decades of the past. To just really kind of speak back to just the limitations and restrictions that have been set, many of you might know I'm a big Disney fan, I'm a big collector, yada yada. But you have to look it up. It's quite interesting because Winnie the Pooh has been banned from China. And when you find the reason why, it's actually quite interesting. So again, looking at the right-hand side, we can see those provinces in which they've been separated, whether it be a municipality or autonomous or just a traditional province. So moving forward into emerging China, the Han Chinese is the largest ethnic group in China, with about 90% of the country's population. The main language in China is Mandarin. It is spoken in different ways in different parts of the country, particularly in the north and the south. The number of languages in China do go over about 290, and different because of the variations and linguistics, but roughly corresponds to the number of ethnic groups in the country, which is quite interesting. So just seeing that every different ethnic group does have its own version or variation, much like you would say with English, right? How people in Kansas or Texas or Tennessee or even in California might speak a different version or variation of English. China's large population has prompted the government to implement a one-child-only policy, which has resulted in a decrease in population growth, but has also caused an imbalance in the percentage of boys and girls being born in many of these provinces. So you kind of go back to when we talked about South Asia, and we saw that in a population graph, how India is now surpassing China, and that has a lot to do with this. So looking at China's periphery, the heart of China has always been part of China proper. Surrounding China proper are a number of autonomous regions, associated territories, and independent countries. These peripheral areas buffer China proper from the rest of the world. Hong Kong is a former British colony and includes a number of islands on the south coast of China. Hong Kong includes an excellent port, Victoria, one of the best in Asia. Taiwan is separate from the Chinese mainland by the Taiwan Strait. In 2010, the population on the island, which is about the size of the state of Maryland, had about 22 million people. The island is mountainous and has a rugged national park in its interior, while most of the people in Taiwan live in the bustling cities that are along the coast, again, working where they live. Located in the mountainous southwestern China, Tibet is classified as one of China's autonomous regions, a disputed political arrangement. Mongolia ranks as the world's 19th largest country in terms of square miles. Mongolia shares a similar geography, similar to Kazakhstan, which is the world's largest landlocked nation, but Mongolia is now the second largest landlocked. So looking also at Japan and Korea. Japan consists of islands that lie along the Pacific Rim, east of China and across the Sea of Japan from the Korean Peninsula. Four islands make up most of the country, each originating from volcanic activities. The country of Japan is an interesting study in isolation, geography as economic development. For centuries, shogun lords and samurai warriors ruled Japan, and Japan's society was highly organized in structures. Urban centers were very well planned, and skilled artisans developed methods of creating high-grade metal products. So what I have on the right-hand side is looking at, essentially the history of Japan. So we can see that you have your Japan's isolation creates a unified empire from 1192 to 1867, 1868. Modernizers would take control, then the Japanese colonial empire, then you have World War II, then you have the rebuilding era, and then you have the post-industrial Japan, which we deal with today. Now looking at Korea, the Korean Peninsula juts out about into the Pacific Rim for the northwestern Asia. The peninsula itself is bound by the Sea of Japan to the east and the Yellow Sea. North and South Korea share the peninsula. About 70% of the Korean Peninsula is mountainous. The bedrock is predominantly composed of volcanic and granite rocks that have been severely modified by glacial processes over the last 25,000 years. The Korean Peninsula can be thought of as four general areas: the western region, the eastern, the southern, and the southwestern region. And I think that's probably the most interesting piece. I've had students who are from South Korea in particular, and I don't know, I just didn't expect South Korea to look the way that it did when I was seeing it through their photos, when they were sharing them with me. And it kind of reminded me a lot of Northern California, Oregon, Washington areas, within how you have that, the Cascades for us, those mountainous volcanic ranges. Quite beautiful landscape. Now, North Korea, the government is a dictatorship continued as the great leader's son, Kim Jong II, took over the leadership role. Kim Jong, known as the Dear Leader, took a repression of his people to new levels. Television and radio sold in North Korea can only receive government-controlled frequencies. Cell phones and the internet are completely banned. The government takes a hard line against dissenters, and if you're caught speaking against the state or taking any action to support dissent, you can be arrested, fined, or placed into a prison camp, and ultimately executed. And obviously we've continued to see continued strife and frustrations and communication, at least, with North Korea, with Kim Jong-un, which is the most recent leader. So South Korea, in 1993, South Korea became a fully fledged democracy with its first democratically elected president. Seoul is the capital city and is home to almost 10 million people. Buddhism was introduced into the Korean Peninsula, as were many other aspects of Chinese culture that have had significant effects on the Korean heritage. Buddhism has been a prominent religion in Korea now for centuries. About 30% of that population claims Christianity as a religious background, 20% are Protestant, and 10% are Catholic. This is the highest Christian percentage of any Asian country, which is pretty interesting. So, a couple questions, let's test this knowledge, and then we'll go from there. So question one, the Three Gorges Dam was constructed to control what, initially? Question two, China's Communist Republic was declared in what year? Question three, which colony was returned to China in 1997 under autonomous arrangements? And question four, Northern Korea lacks arable land to grow food because of why? Again, if you haven't yet, don't forget to hit like on this video, comment below if you have another question, but let's look at the answers. So the Three Gorges Dam was initially designed for flooding, but is also its greatest producer of hydroelectric power. China's Communist Republic was declared in 1949. The colony that was returned to China in 1997 was Hong Kong. And then North Korea lacks arable land because of its mountainous range and the fact that it's just very difficult to grow things in that location. Again, I hope that was helpful. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and